if you want to write your own provisional patent application, there are certain key points to keep in mind. And some of them are made more sense if you keep in mind the statutory purpose of the provisional application. The purpose is to create a filing date that allows you to write claims later in time that are entitled back to the earliest filing date at which subject matter was on file in the patent office. So a provisional patent application is only useful to the extent that it contains content that can support later claims. One of the biggest concerns in writing provisionals is leaving out details, alternatives, dimensions beyond the exact embodiment that you have in mind. So here are a few tips that relate to the drafting of provisionals. One is avoid what we call bad words. These are words of certainty, of absolute. Never say never, never say always, never say critical. I wouldn't even say stop the patient from bleeding. I would say something like, depending upon the desired clinical result, you may want to consider stopping the patient's bleeding. Instead, use open-ended phrases and words of qualification like can, optionally, may, in some embodiments, depending upon the desired clinical outcome. These are phrases that don't limit you when it comes later to writing claims. Also, try to identify genus wherever there's a species involved. For example, if you have a square structure, a round structure, a red structure, a radioactive, those are all species of broader genus. So you need to try to identify every feature in your invention. Are you describing a species, and are there co-species that you should alternatively be describing? For example, you may believe that the stent works best if made out of nitinol. Well, nitinol is obviously a species of a broader genus of pseudoelastic memory metals, and it's not necessarily even limited to metals. In certain instances, there are polymers that exhibit suitable properties. So you would not want to write in your provisional, it must be made out of nitinol, or it is made out of nitinol. You would want to say, it's made out of a metal or a material with suitable physical characteristics to achieve the foregoing results, which you have just described. For example, a superelastic or a memory material, such as nitinol, elgeloy, or others that you may have in mind. Consider also disclosing ranges whenever you have a value. If you believe that 10 microliters per second or 10 centimeters or 10 something is the optimal value for your invention, don't write merely 10. Think about whether 11 would work or 9 would work, and disclose successive ranges. So you might say, consider within the range of from about 5 to 15, sometimes between about 7 and 12, and in one embodiment 10. Or go even broader if in your reasonable guesstimation you think that the sensitivity to that number change is not great. Consider also with ranges whether bigger is better or smaller is better. And that's a situation where you would want to disclose an open-ended range. So if you think 50 is the optimal number that you can achieve, but you know that bigger is better, you're just not sure how to get there, and let's say the prior art is at 10, you might disclose at least about 15, and some embodiments at least about 25 or 30 or 40 or 50 or 75 or more. And those create data points on the basis of which you can write claims down the road. Spend time elaborating in as much detail on what you think the structure is in your invention that differentiates it over the prior art. You don't want to think of an invention as a device as a whole, because normally inventions are really incremental improvements on something which existed in the past. So what you want to focus on is why is yours different structurally, and what is the clinical advantage of that structural difference? That's going to be the focal point of the written description in your provisional patent application. Thank you.